Hi friends, welcome back to the channel Study with Radhika. In this video, we are going to learn a very interesting topic called as Scratch programming. Scratch is a computer programming language that enables you to create your own interactive stories, animation, games, music, and art. Scratch is very easy to learn and use. It provides an interactive environment to create program by dragging block of code. The Scratch programming is also called as block coding. At the end of this video, I have created an interesting game for you by using Scratch programming. So watch till the end. So let's start it from how to start the Scratch. First of all, go to the Start button, choose All Program, and select Scratch 2. The Scratch editor window will appear on the screen. Here I am using the latest version of Scratch 2.0. The Scratch is an open source software, means free to download software. The link I have provided in the description box to download. Before going further, first understand a complete outline of the Scratch editor. Here, this is called a sprite. Sprite is a small graphics character that performs an action in a Scratch project. Scratch provides a number of inbuilt sprites. Here, cat is the default sprite in the Scratch. If you want to change the sprite, easily you can go on the new sprite button at the bottom right corner of the stage. By clicking on this button, we'll open a library dialog box which gives us multiple options of sprite. Select any one sprite and click on OK button. Suppose here I selected ball soccer and click on OK button. Here the sprite will get changed. Here next to the new sprite button, paint new sprite button is available. By clicking this button, we'll open the costume window where we can create our new sprite. Suppose select the brush from here. If you want to change the color, change the color and paint your new sprite. Suppose I'm creating this, the new sprite is appearing on the stage. Like this, you can paint your own sprite. Next to this button, upload sprite from a file button is here. By clicking this button, it will offer the facility to choose a sprite from the files stored in your computer. Suppose here I selected this and click on open. The new sprite will appear on the screen. After selecting a sprite, you can decorate the stage by adding a backdrop. To add the backdrop, click on this button, choose background from library. By clicking this button, a backdrop library dialog box will open, which gives us multiple options of background. Select any one background and click on OK. Suppose I selected this one and click on OK. The backdrop will display on the stage. Again here, next to the new background button, paint new background button is available. By clicking this button, we'll open a costume window where we can create our own new background. Next to this button, upload background from file button is here. By clicking this button, it will offer the facility to choose background from the file stored in your computer system. Here, camera like button is called a new backdrop from camera. This option allows your web camera to click an image and use it as a backdrop. Now, next component of the Scratch programming is stage. This area is the main working area where the sprite moves and perform an action as per given instruction. Here you can watch stories, play games, and run Scratch project that you have created. Here on top left corner, the button is called View Full Screen Mode. This enables you to view your presentation of your project in the full screen mode. See, like this. To go back again in the normal mode, click on this button, you'll go back again your sc- scratch window editor. These buttons are called a cursor tool. In this, first button is called duplicate. This creates a duplicate copy of the selected sprite. For example, click on the duplicate button and click on that sprite which you want to duplicate. Suppose this one, click on that, the sprite will get duplicate. Next to this button, delete button is there. Suppose unnecessary sprite you want to delete it from your stage, you can click. Suppose the cat is unnecessary here, click on this, it will get deleted. One more football, click on that. Click on delete button, delete. It will get deleted from the stage. Next to this button, grow button is there. It helps us to increase the size of the sprite. Suppose I want to increase the size of this sprite, select the grow button and click on the sprite. It will increase slowly. After this, next to the grow button, shrink button is there. Suppose I want to decrease the size of the sprite, click on the sprite. The size will get decreased. Like this, you can grow and shrink your sprite by using the grow and shrink button. Here, green flag is here. By this flag, the execution of the scratch programming will get started. Next to this button, red button is there. The stop button is used to stop the execution of the program. Now come on blocks. These blocks are referred to as a group of command. Some blocks are given here: motion block, looks block, sound block, pen block, data block, event block, control block, sensing block, operator block, more block. In the more block, you can create your own blocks. Now here, this area is called block palettes area. Suppose I click on motion block, the block palettes are available here. Each block contains a list of commands. This area is called a script area. Script area is a place where you can create a script for a sprite to do a particular task. The script is created by dragging the instruction from the blocks palette and dropping them stepwise on the top of each other. Now, how to drag and drop the blocks? Left click on any block, hold and drag it to the script area and drop here. Like this, you can drop more blocks from blocks palette to script area. Again, see the example like this. Left click, hold and drag and drop here. Like this. Script is a collection of the stepwise instructions that are given to the sprite to do the specific task. Here you are familiar with all the components given on the Scratch editor window. At the starting of this video, I told you that I have created an interesting game for you. So now it's time to show you that. Here is that your interesting game. First, view this in a full screen mode. Here I have given here a score box. Whenever you will click on this balloon, your score will get increased. See now, click on the green flag to execute the program. That you have to click on the balloon, then your score will get increased. By clicking on the balloon, easily you can score . Now how to stop this? To stop this, click on the red button. The execution of the program will get stopped. Click on the normal button, you will come on normal screen. So in the next video, we will create more games like this, and I will tell you how to create a game stories and animation in using Scratch programming. If you like this video, please subscribe, like and share. Thank you.